All right. Today was pretty crazy. got off to a funny start. Obviously, I'm like an hour late. I'm running this software that allows me to do all this fancy stuff that you're seeing on the right and the left and all that, whatever. And with that software, I don't know. Got a lot of work to do to keep that going, which actually isn't that much work. But apparently, I had been running a version of it that should have been incompatible with the Mac that I have, because I've got this really old Mac, because I'm, well, it's not even mine. This isn't even my computer. Someone's letting me use this computer to do this with you. That's the level of whatever is going on here. Anyways, yeah. So the software I'm using is apparently not even supposed to be usable on the computer I have yet. We did this yesterday. You were here with me. If you're not, even if you weren't here with me yesterday, there's a stream to prove it that's archived on Twitch. So I had to redo it, and I had to redo this whole formatting thing and download a whole new software. Same software, just a much older version that would work with this computer. So here we are, blah blah blah, whatever. Some formatting things I'll have to fix along the way, but I really just wanted to kind of get everything back up and running for today. So yeah. Welcome to Tuesday of the Shared Element, and the bumps in the road are the textures of our souls. All right. I don't know who's here, if anybody's here. I don't know if you are. Who's here? Say hi if you are. I'd love to hear from you. my quote of the day. I thought this morning was an unreasonable thing to happen to me, and so I decided I would remind myself the nature of reason. Adorno. The concept of the primacy of reason contains the idea that reason has the task of taming, suppressing, ordering, and governing whatever is unreasonable, instead of absorbing it into itself in a spirit of reconciliation. Thus, this notion of reason as domination is inherent in the concept of reason from its inception, and the idea of conflict is implicit in it from the outset. Theodore Adorno. History and Freedom, 1964-65. It's a set of lectures this guy named Adorno, German thinker, gave in the mid-60s. He wrote a lot about aesthetics and this idea of dialectic. And this is actually the only thing of his I've read, is this set of lectures called History and Freedom, which is maybe terrible of me. Maybe it's just terrible. Terrible. I'm the worst. All right. I didn't eat breakfast this morning because I was dealing with this, so. Breakfast of Champions. I might try and go grab some berries here in a minute. I got some blueberries and some raspberries in the fridge. Anyways, today, I'm just gonna keep working on the stuff I've been working on, listen to some Christian Wolf. I'm not gonna use this whole mirror image thing. The day I do, call me. Tell my family. Friends are the family you choose. And I choose all of you, if you'll have me. if you thought that was desperate, you should watch a couple movies with me. I have to text someone and let them know that I got this working because I was desperately engaging with them this morning trying to figure it out. All right. Yeah, now that I'm texting on webcam, I'm officially the worst human being I've ever met. But here we are. All right. So, yeah, I'd love to hear from any of you who are happening right now. I'm all about it. Bring me your vibes. I want to feel you. I'm going to go ahead and get started. I'm going to go up some berries, actually. And then I think I'm just going to read a little bit this morning. This book treated me so lovely yesterday. I'm like already halfway through it. But wow, did I get a lot out of it. I put a couple of quotes in the chat yesterday, and then I recited one of the quotes from it at the end of the stream. So those are all there. Still on Twitch. I haven't put them on YouTube yet. Gotta figure that out. But, yeah. Alright. So, welcome to the party. Let me know how you're feeling. Good morning, still. I'm hungry because I didn't eat breakfast and I had a few blueberries, but I'm gonna go eat lunch now. Eat some potatoes, you know, do my thing. Says I've got two people watching right now because I figured out how technology works. So, hello, Magical 2. Good to see you. And, yeah. I think that I need to just go eat now. Sarah's just pouring at me everything that he feels and thinks, which I'm totally into. Need to read more. He left me in a weird spot. It's alright. I think after I eat, I'm gonna start writing. Instead of reading, write some new things. We were just listening to Christian Wolf. He's American, kind of associated with the New York school of John Cage, Morton Feldman, these kinds of like experimental music people. And in exploring an idea that's important to me, freedom and necessity, as it relates to many great things. Christian Wolf's music is a very lovely example of that. A lot of it being a backdoor kind of experience. The paper he uses, the notation to communicate with the performers, this relationship of freedoms and necessities, comes across in the way the music is realized, the way people are able to play his music. One of my favorite things about him is taking the same piece, like Tilbury. That's the one we started with. Tilbury. There are quite a few different recordings of Tilbury out there, and a couple for solo piano. The one I listened to is an ensemble piece that also has strings and a trombone. And so it's like a smaller kind of quartet group, and the difference between these different recordings, obviously there's different instruments in different recordings. How did he do that? That's on the next episode. But the open nature of the score, even between the two piano recordings, is quite stark in some of the how the moods can be so different, but then also you feel the relationships of similarity between them. So it takes familiarity, I think. You have to listen to these pieces back to 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 back. And to really start sussing out what is similar between them and them not just feel like these kind of arbitrarily different pieces of music with the same name. How do you start feeling what organizes them? What unites this energy? What is the same? And once you can do that, you'll start getting a sense for how that performer is different. You really start getting a sense for that person, the person playing, the group of interpreters who have taken on the music. You start getting a sense for what they have to offer. And that's really beautiful for me. Like, a lot of music written now in more like popular idioms, right? Like, good metal band or two. We'll listen to some Kralis after this because I'm one of those losers who likes Kralis. at me, bro. At me. At me. Kralis. Igher. Loom. Two of the best metal albums of this decade. Bring it. anyways, when you listen to a lot of more popular musics where the people who wrote it are the ones playing it, you get a very clear relationship. And a lot of classical music is very divorced of that relationship. In my experience and other people's experience of who I've talked to, the performer ends up not mattering that as much. You know, there's this kind of threshold of doing it well. There's this nuance of interpretation, which ends up only really mattering to music students and specialists. in a lot of ways. You put on a playlist for Mozart, and it's just gonna play whatever, and people are pretty hyped just to be hearing some 151, you know? And a little bit of twinkly do and some like be dee dum be dum bum ba whatever. You probably just thought of clacking there. That wasn't very useful. The webcam, the mic, it's all on the table. That was probably just really terrible. I'm not good at this whole thing. Figured it out. Anyways, I'm hungry. And I gotta write an out to lunch sign. Because my current out to lunch sign is a temporary phenomenon that needs to change every day. Out to lunch. What time is it? I'm just putting 11:45. It's 11:47, but I'm gonna put 11:45 to about 12:30. It won't take me that long, but in my kitchen, because that's where I eat. Well, that's where I cook. I'll probably eat in here with you guys. All two of you. Whoever's here. Who is here? Did anybody say anything? Do I have any friends? No, everybody left. Okay. Well, you all left, so it's okay. No one's here. Nobody cares. No, I know you care. You're all just busy. It's fine. You're lovely. Thank you. Thank you. Yo. I maybe made a bit too much food. That's like definitely possible. But I'm hungry. So I'm gonna go in. And that's just fine, you know? Just dandy. Yeah,
definitely possible.
Yeah, so what's up? Just gonna eat some lunch here before I get back to work. I'm chilling. Oh, I'll probably eat it all, like, no doubt. I didn't have breakfast, so, because I was too busy trying to deal with all of this morning. So I didn't eat anything. So I had some blueberries. So that's a lie. I did eat some blueberries. That was delicious. But here we are. Hot. Oh my god. It's so hot. Wow! Enjoy practicing, man. Yeah. I'm just gonna chill here. I mean, if you don't wanna talk to me, I'm just gonna eat my food. That's a threat. We have these huge bowls, by the way. Like, this bowl's huge. It's pen for scale. It's like, look at this. The pen just goes around the bowl. This isn't a small pen. It's a big bowl. I don't know how to give you a better sense of this bowl here. I was really excited about it for a second, but it's fine. I'm making tea right now. That's the most exciting thing happening in this moment. So when the whistle... Oh, never mind. Duty calls. I might have to find a different format of engaging with the lunchtime thing because it's built under this expectation that, like, people will be here to talk to, and it's okay if nobody wants to talk to me. Because there's shit to do. This book's wild. He gets a bit, particular. in a way I've never felt in his writing. His writing is usually his writing is very open to whatever energy you can bring to it. Lots of room for interpretation, that kind of thing. But he's kind of laying it out in this book, just kind of like, no, this is how I feel. It's interesting. Because I have expectations of what I go to Sarah for. Because I'm a monster with all my expectations. And I just never thought I would know how he felt about anything. For anybody watching the stream, at any point, help me out with how everything looks. Like on my side, some of the text looks a bit fuzzy, and I think that has something to do with me just rushing through getting some format version of this up for today, which I'll mess with a bit tonight. But if you've got any feedback, things you'd like to see, things you'd like to not see, including my face, let me know. So I think getting this problem-solving stuff out of the way, like ASAP, fluidity of process, all that, would be great. I'm definitely going to eat it all. Thank you. QED. I just went out of Clementine because I wanted it. And I'm lucky to be able to buy groceries and do that. So there we are. I guess I should just talk about the project more often for now. Get people used to what's going on. Yeah, I mean, this isn't some elaborate set in some studio somewhere. Yeah, this is where I live. This is what I do every day. These pieces of paper are not paid actors. They are my friends. By being here and doing this every day, it's kind of, strange, I guess. I'm not looking to act or put on some kind of front or exhibit some form of entertainment for anyone. All of this points towards, like, Fridays, right? Fridays being the day in which you get to share with me and the world through the internet what matters to you. Just so this page will be a bit different on Fridays. Right now it's got what I'm listening to, it's got what I'm currently reading, it's got movies I've recently watched, it's got my quote of the day, it's got things that I think about, and things that I love, and things that I do, and it's just wrapped up in seeing the kind of mythology I make for myself, and or that's makes up me, whatever. We could talk about it. Don't have to, I guess. Yeah, I think, I mean, it's frightening in a way for me. I mean, it also seems a bit silly to just, like, put my stuff on the internet. Like, this is what I do. Look at it. Like, okay, thanks, guy. It's also the way I want to be living. I want to be making music. I want to be consuming art that I find meaningful, that helps me think in different ways, that helps me understand in different ways, which then in turn helps me engage with people in different ways. Because people aren't always happy with how they're engaged with, not necessarily by me per se, but like in general, people just aren't like happy with the way they're engaged with in the world. They aren't satisfied with the way they present themselves and the world treats them in response to that. And so I hope, you know, that's a, there's some like grand naive scope for you, I guess. I'd like to be able to be a part of making some of that a little different. For everybody who wants it to be a little different. Yeah. So, you three viewers right now, you're killing it. I feel wild, like, obsessively looking at my phone to see if people are there or not. I don't know why. I'll probably get used to it and get over it, but it's a new process I'm working through. Yeah, I'm really excited for Friday. I'm really excited for, the chance to feel what matters to you guys and have to sit in this awkward space of not knowing anything about it, most likely, and do something about that. Yeah. On a very local level, this feels a little silly, you know? It'll definitely feel silly setting up a webcam, sitting at my desk, making sure it's at a right angle where you can see me. I mean, I'd be sitting here anyways. This is where I would be anyways. Doing what I do. But if I wasn't meant to work today, you know? If I wasn't meant to go to my day job, which I've taken time off from to try and do this. I've saved up a bit of money. I don't think I've even said this in my chat necessarily. I've saved up a good bit of money. And to where I can do this for the next month or two, you know, and really just give this a shot and see how it goes. And that's what the Patreon's for, to try and create a space in which people who support me in doing what I do can let me keep doing it. And people that are also excited about having that platform that I'm creating, this kind of open-ended space for sharing in this kind of closed-circuited way, open-ended, but closed circuit, you know? Yeah. That's what I'm looking for. And, I think with that, it's 12:30. I've been on lunch break for about 45 minutes now. I think it's time for me to get back to doing what I do, and hopefully you're doing what you want to do, and, if not, I hope you get the chance to work on that. Because, yeah. That's all I'm going to say. Thank you.